Senior year, Morehouse, working five. And G Tech was here, you were doing all the outreach stuff. So when I was a grad student, I kept coming to see you to take Pete in the box with all the bio parts to all the schools in Atlanta. And your office was that little corner room at IDB with all the junk. But, but I just want to say, retirement, wow, you're setting a model for everyone here, because again, people here don't retire. I will miss you personally as you moved up and you take on different positions, and I now have to find out who to email when someone says, I want to find a job. But I think you're amazing, so thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah, go ahead.
Well, Sally, I guess I take a lot of credit giving you your first job here. That was one of the best things I did. One of the worst things I did was to lose you to BME. But that turned out to be one of the best things for BME. So, thank you for just everything you've done. You've not only done a very special job, but you've done it in a very special way because you are a very special person. Thank you for everything.
Thank you. Appreciate that.
Janet,
please come up.
And from one mom to another, and a counselor to another, I remember I went out on maternity leave from the admission office, and about 8 days after Emma was born, I got a call from Sally saying, I want you to come interview for this job. And I pulled out one of the maternity dresses because that's all I had. I don't know how I remembered my name, versus much less make an impression on you and Steve. But you hired me, and you have helped me grow personally and professionally as someone who looks at each person's strengths and challenges and differences and encourages and accepts us for who we are, where we are, and helps us grow. And thanks for all that.
I'll just keep this real simple. I am going to miss your smiling face every morning. You're so positive, and no one knows a party or Halloween party like you.
So
enjoy
retirement.
Stop in, see us every once in a while.
Miss
you.
Thank you.
You never gave me any mom advice.
I feel like I've been left out. Well, being following up on Bob too, being responsible for the person who stole you from Bob. You remember Dominique Durant? You owe your job to him.
Oh, okay.
Dominique Durand was one of our first advisory board members.
Oh, right,
and,
right.
One of the best piece of advice this department ever received is from him saying, you guys need to hire your own person to help your grads find jobs. Back when you started, that was like 20 students a year. It's grown a little bit since then. I would say that your contributions as department have been immeasurable. And looking back, in terms of what you've represented, I think there's one metric that really stands out in my mind. About every 3 or 4 years, we do the alumni survey. And yes, I give you a hard time about your sophisticated database for keeping track of alumni. That spreadsheet, yes. But every year, we somehow seem to get a response rate that is just off the charts. And when I share with other colleagues at the universities that, we don't routinely get 60-70% response rate from our alumni surveys, like, how do you do that? We need to know. And I said, no, you can't have them. Because it's not only the keeping track of where they are, but the fact that you have that contact with them, build up that reputation, hands-on, caring about them. I mean, they want to respond, they want to contribute. I think that is just a remarkable measure of what kind of impact you've had on how many alumni now?
2,000. I don't remember.
A lot. And I just wanted to say thank you for everything you've done.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it. It's been good. Thank you.
Well, Sally is responsible for me coming into the academic office at BME. I started with the neuro lab, but she gave me an opportunity to come to the academic side from administrative. She had helped me raise my kids. I'm sorry. She has helped me raise my kids. She has been the woman who taught me how to curb attitude. In the professional world, I still haven't learned it, but it's more refined. When she first told me I need to bring it down a notch, and kind of gave me that mom, you know, version of, you know, that's just not how you act. But anyway, she has often referred to me as Katie as, as her child, that we have the same attitude. So it's just been such a great, just a great career building woman inspirational time to be in, around. I'm going to miss you so much. You know, I think no one else can do this job. I've told you that, but, you know, I know at some point you have to retire, like I told my mom. I'm so happy that you are getting the opportunity to do what they do with Ken, to spend the rest of you all life. I'm really hoping that that show comes out. She knows the show I'm talking about, but I won't spoil the surprise for everybody. But I just thank you so much for being there for our students, for us, for being a part of this team, for bonding us, building us in the academic office. And again, I'm just gonna miss you so much.
Thank you. Well, Sally, congratulations. I had the pleasure of working with Sally a lot on the finance side, and it was definitely an honor to have the pleasure of working with you. I wanted to do this on the video, but I didn't get a chance to do it on the video, but it speaks volumes that I truly believe that heroes don't only wear capes and now. But heroes wear a great smile and a great spirit, and you're one of those heroes to us all. And I wanted to sing a little snippet of that. Did you ever know that you're my hero? You're everything I would like to be. I can fly higher than the eagle. Sally, you're the wind in me. Our wings. Thank you so much.